Welcome, family and friends. Thank you for being here today as we celebrate the union of Sophie Vang and Jeremiah Starling. This occasion not only marks the beginning of their marriage, but is a commemoration of their love, nurtured and shared between them. Today, they embark on a new life together, built on the foundation of trust, compassion, and mutual respect. Who escorts Sophie today? Please respond, I do, or we do. As you are joined in hands, Sophie, do you take Jeremiah as your cherished husband in front of these witnesses, promise to stay by his side through sickness and in health, joy and sorrow, so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Jeremiah, do you take Sophie as your cherished wife in front of these witnesses and promise to stay by her side through sickness and in health, joy and sorrow, so long as you both shall live?
I do.
A wedding is such a special event. It's more than just today. It's all that has led up to this day. It's remembering the first time that you've met Sophie and Jeremiah as a couple, whether that's at work, at Disneyland, after a four-hour trip to Las Vegas. It's getting to know Sophie and Jeremiah as a couple. Jeremiah and his amazing ability to blend in any social situation, his gift to make you feel understood and connected, Sophie's beautiful smile that's as warm as her hospitality, her ability to give a hug. It's not just a hug. You know you're more than just a friend, you're family. It's learning about all the care and the timing that was put into Jeremiah's proposal, all the precision that was needed to create not only a memorable moment for Sophie, but an inclusive event for Jacob. A wedding is watching the proposal become Facebook official. A wedding is hearing about all the details coming together, finding the dress, the venue, the trips to Joann Fabric and Michaels, or Sophie becoming a Cricut guru. A wedding is family and friends coming together, in some cases meeting for the very first time, playing games, enjoying some well-deserved pampering. All the people who are special to you in your life coming together, knowing they just have one thing in common, and that's knowing and loving the bride and groom. And that's enough to create friendships and connections. During the bridal shower, I was able to connect with Sophie's cousin. We traveled from one destination to another, and we chatted in the Southern California traffic, so we talked a lot. I learned of her passion to inspire. So naturally, I turned to her for words for today. And she said, "You know you found the one when your future becomes clear, when you feel like you can conquer the world, you become more of who you truly are." These are words by Diana Nguyen. Becoming more of who you truly are. That is what we celebrate. Jeremiah, the meticulous planner, making sure all avenues have been researched, all details in place. All boxes crossed, problem solving when things can't go originally as planned, but doing all with a smile on his face and making you feel at ease. Sophie, in all the thoughtful details surrounding today, pouring her beautiful heart into every aspect of the wedding. Mindful on budget, generous on sentiment and love. Probably should have told you all to sit down, I'm sorry. Sophie has all the details in mind. She poured her beautiful heart into every aspect of this wedding, mindful of budget and generous on sentiment and love, making sure that the other engaged ladies at her own bridal shower were celebrated. And that spirit is famous because as she was doting over the other ladies, I heard somebody say, "That's our Sophie." We all have witnessed your future becoming clearer, both you becoming more of who you truly are during your courtship, your engagement, and witnessing your marriage. By being who you truly are and allowing others to shine as they are, Together, you're going to conquer whatever life presents. In doing just that, you've already created a beautiful home and a beautiful family. And now, you're going to create a future as husband and wife. Marriage isn't easy. It takes compromise, patience, empathy, and love. But when you're partnered with the one who loves you unconditionally, the one who celebrates you and appreciates your strengths, embraces your weaknesses, you work through all that life throws your way. Diana provided me with one final thought. She said, "Love is when your heart and mind are finally both at peace. Doubts have faded away, and you finally understand why people say, marry your best friend." So with that in mind, take a deep breath. Release your fears and your anxiety. Know that we are all witnessing you, Sophie, and Jeremiah, joining together with the one. Today, you are your true self, and you're going to continue life's journey with your best friend by your side. Sophie, Jeremiah, hand in hand, are we in agreement to proceed with respect and love? If so, please respond, we do.
We do.
At this time, I'm going to ask the couple to share their vows.
Okay, I'm going to start this off with a quote. You know you're in love when you can't fall asleep. Because reality is finally better than your dream. I knew you were the one when we started dating, and I would say countless times to my friends and family that I'm terrified that someone would wake me up from this dream.
I'll hold it.
Thank you. And that this, you are all too good to be true. But dreams do come true, and you are my reality. The man of my dreams is here, standing in front of me today. You make falling in love with you so easy. Everything just makes sense with you. I love spending and cherishing every waking moment with you. I knew you were the one because you offer unconditional love and support. You pick me up when I am down, offer encouragement when I need it most. You give me strength when I feel defeated. I've waited for a long time for you. I've waited a long time to smile and laugh every day with no worries. I've waited a long time to find someone who I could build a family with, and here we are today. Sorry, thank you. Oh my After we met, I knew my life could never be the same because before I met you, I had given up on finding the one. I was convinced that there would be nobody out there that would understand my sense of humor, my quirky ways, or the way I love to laugh at my own jokes. Someone knows that too. I was pretty convinced until the day when you came into my life. Today is the beginning of the rest of our lives. I choose to spend my today and all of my tomorrows with you. I vow to continue to love you more and more every day and stand by your side when you need it most. I vow to share in your dreams and encourage you to continue growing as an individual as we work toward our mutual goals. I vow to give you patience, honesty, respect, and unwavering love as you have given to me.
You know how I know you're the one? We picked the same quote, the star.
Did we really? Oh my god. Did we really?
So, Dr. Seuss once said, you know you're in love when you can't fall asleep because reality is.
Are you kidding? Oh my god, are you kidding?
And that can't sum up any better how I knew you were the one. Before you, a soulmate was only something I had read or dreamed about. But then suddenly, that dream was a reality. But the reality was so much more amazing than what I could possibly envision in a dream. You are more incredible than any soulmate I could ever invent or imagine in all my wildest dreams. Today is the beginning of the rest of our lives. I vow to spend today and all of my tomorrows with you.
Sorry, my bad.
I vow to be the one you wake up next to under sun and through rain, amidst life's thick and thin, no matter the weight of the world on our shoulders. Despite my faults and shortcomings, I vow to be everything you will ever need in a husband, a friend, a father, and the love of your life. And I will never turn my back on my pledge to you today. I will love you, cherish you, and I will stand by your side for all my life, which you and our son have blessed. I vow to make our every day the dream come true that you and that we deserve and more. This is my promise, and this is my heart, which I give to you today. Love you. Scary.
Thank you. Sorry, make sure I got the right one. Okay. The wedding ring perfectly symbolizes the never-ending love you two have for one another. By exchanging these rings, you're solidifying your lifelong commitment to one another. The rings serve as a welcome and constant reminder of the bond you've formed with your partner. Sophie, please place the ring on Jeremiah's finger. Repeat after me. I, Sophie, give you, Jeremiah, this ring.
I, Sophie, give you, Jeremiah, this ring.
As a symbol of my enduring love.
As a symbol of my enduring love.
Just as the circle of the ring completes itself.
Just as the circle of the ring completes itself.
So you complete me.
So you complete me.
Jeremiah, please put the ring on Sophie's finger. And repeat after me. I, Jeremiah, give you, Sophie, this ring.
I, Jeremiah, give you, Sophie, this ring.
As a symbol of my enduring love.
As a symbol of my enduring love.
Just as the circle completes itself.
Just as the circle completes itself.
So you complete me.
So you complete me.
Sophie, Jeremiah, by the powers vested in me, in the Universal Life Church in the state of California, I am pleased to pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, I have the privilege and the pleasure of presenting Mr. and Mrs. Jeremiah and Sophie Starling.